Hello and welcome to my highlights of 2025 with SAP Datasphere. What a great year it has been. Let me share a few of my personal highlights of the year. The first one, obviously, being SAP Business Data Cloud. The announcement of SAP Business Data Cloud in February this year made quite some noise and puts data, analytics, and AI at the center of our portfolio at SAP. We delivered Business Data Cloud in May as a fully managed software as a service solution that unifies and governs all SAP data and seamlessly connects with third-party data. It is really an evolution of our business data fabric journey we started with SAP Datasphere and SAP Analytics Cloud some years ago, and also offers a path forward for your investments in SAP BW. Delivering out-of-the-box, always-on data products is the next pivotal step in our data strategy, following a harmonized data model to provide scalable access without duplication using zero-copy delta share technology. So Business Data Cloud serves as the foundation for your data and AI projects, leveraging SAP-managed and custom data products. And of course, using our growing open partner ecosystem with Databricks and the newly announced partnerships with Google BigQuery, Snowflake, and Microsoft Fabric. So the future is really bright. But now, let us also have a look at my top features of SAP Datasphere in 2025. The first one is the Object Store. In 2025, we delivered the option to include an Object Store next to the well-known HANA cloud-based persistency for a cost-efficient storage. You can use the existing tooling you already know to create local tables on files, use replication flows, transformation flows, which are then using Spark as a compute engine and all orchestrated by task chains. So you can now load large quantities of data via replication flows, prepare the data using transformation flows, and then share data to other spaces to be used as a source for additional flows, views, and of course, analytical models. So a really great enhancement. The next one, object versioning. So object versions have been introduced for views, analytic models, data access controls, and local tables. The new object versions are created automatically at the time of deployment, which allows you now to list the past versions of objects, open a past version in read-only mode in a new tab to compare it to the other one, download a past version to a season JSON file, and restore a past version to replace the current version. So be aware that the saving of an error-free restored version overrides the current object. It is also important to understand that the versioning happens for the metadata of an object and not the data. Then there are tons of smaller enhancements that have been delivered in 2025 to increase the efficiency and the productivity overall. Let me just name here a few. On the analytic model side, we introduced stacking and the reusing of analytic models. We now support structures and data access controls for analytic models. We introduced a measure dependency graph, the fiscal time dimension and unit conversion, and many enhancements with variables and parameters. On the replication flow side, we introduced delta-only load type, the support for views, reusing source objects in multiple flows, and many new sources and targets. On the transformation flow side, we introduced batch processing, parameter support, HANA tables as a source in Spark transformation flows, and other features, bringing the Spark transformation flows almost on par with the HANA cloud-based ones. On the task chain side, we introduced deep retry of failed task chains, specifically for nested task chains, The REST API was introduced, as well as parameter support and notification tasks, amongst other improvements. On the catalog side, we now support BW4HANA for crawling, as well as seamless planning, BDC, data products, Databricks via BDC Connect. We introduced GenAI assisted generation of catalog asset descriptions and classifications, and mass import functions of existing glossaries, terms, KPIs, and etc. from flag files. Further enhancements and checks in the view analyzer, as well as the data validation framework. We introduced the capacity unit dashboard for better monitoring, and so many more enhancements in the data builder, administration, elastic compute nodes, command line interface, and other areas of the product. SAP Datasphere is now integrated into the SAP Cloud Application Lifecycle Management for health, job, and automation monitoring. So the health monitoring enables you to check the health of one or more Datasphere tenants from the health monitoring app in Cloud ALM to check, for example, on memory and disk usage, out of memory events, task failures, and admission control events. The job and automation monitoring enables you to monitor task runs and executions in one or more Datasphere tenants from the job and automation monitoring app in Cloud ALM. This integration overall eases the monitoring of an SAP Datasphere tenant in a complex customer landscape with a centralized and consistent way of tracking of the tenants. In addition, the early watch alert reports are also now available for SAP Datasphere. Early watch alert is an automatic service analyzing the essential administrative areas of your SAP systems and covered by your maintenance agreement. Data access controls based on identity provider attributes are a small enhancement, but it's super powerful. You can now use values in custom attributes provided by your identity provider as identifiers in your data access controls and define conditions that apply to users with these values. Why is it powerful? Because using these attributes allows you to apply a single condition to all users whose accounts contain that specific attribute value. Meaning, you can now group these users with attributes to assign permissions to a group instead of to individual users. So, all in all, very cool features helping you to use SAP Datasphere way more efficiently. Thanks for joining me this month for my feature highlight overview of 2025. In 2026, I will also integrate Business Data Cloud more and more into these videos as new and useful features come into the solution. If you liked it, give me a thumbs up down here and keep following me on LinkedIn. And also, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest updates. Take care and see you soon.